Nandi Gram, Wikipedia article audio. Nandi Gram is a census town in Nandi Gram I community development block in Haldia subdivision of Purba Medinipur district of the Indian state of West Bengal. It is located about 70 kilometers southwest of Kolkata, on the south bank of the Haldi River, opposite the industrial city of Haldia. The area falls under the Haldia Development Authority. Demographics. Police Station. People of Nandi Gram. Conflict over proposed chemical hub. Health. Transport. Education. In 2007, the West Bengal government decided to allow Salim Group to set up a chemical hub at Nandi Gram under the Special Economic Zone policy. This led to resistance by the villagers, resulting in clashes with the police that left 14 villagers dead, and accusations of police brutality. As per 2011 census of India, Nandi Gram had a total population of 5,803, of which 2,947 were males and 2,856 were females. Population below 6 years was 725. The total number of literates in Nandi Gram was 4,512. Nandi Gram Police Station has jurisdiction over Nandi Gram I and Nandi Gram II Community Development Block. Nandi Gram Police Station covers an area of 251.25 kilometers two with a population of 279,285. Although this part of Bengal has not been actively highlighted in Indian history during British period, the area had been a part of active politics from the British era. With the help of the people of Nandi Gram, Tamluk was freed from the British by Ajoy Mukherjee, Sushil Kumar Dhera, Satish Chandra Samanta and their friends for a few days, before India gained de facto freedom in 1947. In post-independent India, Nandi Gram had been a centre of learning and played a major part in the development of Haldia, a satellite town of Calcutta. Fresh vegetables, rice and fish are being supplied to Haldia from Nandi Gram. Like Haldia, Nandi Gram has a natural strategic geographic location for business and farming. The Ganga and Haldi cover the edges of Nandi Gram, and thereby the land is fertile by both the rivers. Although 25% of the area has a Muslim population, but this area has never been in the clutches of Hindu-Muslim riot. The Nandi Gram town is dominated by Brahmins. Late Nalinaksha Nanda, son of late Trailakyanath Nanda and Giribala Devi, a son of the soil, held the post of Deputy Secretary of Home Department in Writers Buildings during the 70s. The controversy over the state government plan to build a chemical hub in Nandi Gram led opposition parties to organize against the acquisition of land. The Trinamool Congress, Bharatiya Janata Party, Socialist Unity Centre of India, and Indian National Congress cooperated to establish the Bhumi Uch Pratirad Committee. A large number of erstwhile supporters of the ruling CPI party also joined them. The apparent aim of the BUPC was to protect the farmers' lands. However, the top leadership of the ruling party, determined to ride roughshod over all opposition, painted the agitation as one against industrialization. The official propaganda carried by pro-government media talked of jobs for the large number of unemployed youths of the state of West Bengal and made claims of a boost to development in the area. According to the version propagated by the party, the region would have become an industrial belt and would have attracted further investments and jobs to the state. The main opposition party, the TMC, maintains, however, that they are opposed not to industrialization per se but poorly planned projects carried out with inhuman methods. The situation came to a head when the MP from nearby Haldia took a proactive role in the project. The Haldia Development Authority under him issued a notice for land acquisition. Several supporters of both the CPI and the BUPC were violently attacked by opponents with their houses vandalized. Both sides amassed huge quantities of arms and several clashes resulted in incidents allegedly of arson, murder, and rape. However, the BUPC got the upper hand owing to its commanding greater public support and allegedly supported by Maoists, did not allow police and CPI cadre to enter for over 3 months by digging up roads. When the ruling party sought to re-establish its previous domination, it mobilized the administration in the name of removing blockades and restoring normalcy. On the night of March 14, 2007, the party's cadre, allegedly bolstered by hired hardened criminals from the state and outside, conducted a joint operation with the state police. They unleashed a reign of terror, killing at least 14 people, maiming many more and allegedly committing numerous infanticides and rapes. There were allegations of removal of evidence in the form of dead bodies and injured persons. Several writers, artists, poets, and academicians took a strong position against the police firing, which in turn brought significant international attention. However, there has been some division among the intelligentsia in Bengal. While Maheswita Devi, Aparna Sen, Sayanli Mitra, Suvaprasanna, Joy Goswami, Kabir Suman, Bratia Basu, along with noted environment activist Medha Patkar, condemned the government, Sumitra Chatterjee, Nirendranath Chakraborty, Tarun Majumdar defended the chief minister on development issue. Just after the bloodbath of Nandigram on March 14, pro-government intellectuals have spoken in favor of the chief minister, which includes the novelists Buday Deb Guha and Debesh Roy, the literateur Amitava Shadhuri, the poet Malika Sengupta, the actors Dilip Roy, Sabyasachi Chakrabarty, and Usha Ganguly, the singers Amar Pal, Shivendu Mehti, Utpalendu Shadhuri, and Indranil Sen, the Sarad exponent Buday Dev Dasgupta, the historian Anuruddha Roy, the football luminary P.K. Banerjee, the noted architect Sailapati Guha, the scientist Saroy Ghosh, and the poet Nirendranath Chakravarti, who presided over a gathering at Science City Auditorium, Kolkata. According to media reports in the gathering, the noted leftist novelist Debesh Roy stated no private investment was made in West Bengal between 1947 and 2005, and the then Chief Minister Mr. Buday Deb Bhattacharjee made the first successful effort in this regard. Mr. Roy in the same public gathering also claimed no country in this world has offered so much compensation to farmers as the left front government. I will make a public apology if I am proved wrong. Mr. Roy's statements were challenged and refuted with data in a letter to the editor by a researcher in the field in the same newspaper in which he was quoted. However, noted leftist intellectuals such as Sumit Antonika Sarkar, Praful Bidwai and Sanka Ghosh refused to buy the argument in favor of development and remained critical of the government. One interesting side of the widespread protest against land expropriation in Nandigram by the then left front government was the silence of the opposition parties and the intellectuals just about a decade ago, when large-scale land acquisition accompanied with protests by the farmers took place in the rural areas of the erstwhile Midnapur district of West Bengal. As a direct aftermath of the West Bengal government's special economic zone policy, in the panchayat elections of May 2008, CPI and its left front allies were defeated in Nandigram and adjoining areas by the Trinamool Congress SUCI alliance. The Trinamool Congress SUCI alliance and the Congress wrested the Zilla Parishads from the CPIM in three districts of the 16 districts of West Bengal out of the hands of CPI after about 30 years. In March 2001, Nandigram 2 block of Medinipur district claimed to have achieved full toilet coverage in the entire block. There is no rail connection directly to Nandigram, and roadways are not ill-developed. Buses, jitney trekkers, and van rickshaws are the primary public vehicles inside the villages. Nearest railway station, Magrajapur, connected from Dingha, Tomluk. Nearest busy bus stop, Shandipur. 5 to 7 direct buses are available from Howrah station, while other direct buses ply from Dingha, Haldia, Jiankali, Mekata. Tekkers at half an hour interval are available from Shandipur. Nandigram is connected by ferry with Haldia. This ferry service is an important mode of transport for farmers and small traders of Nandigram, who uses this service to reach Haldia market for selling their commodities. Haldia municipality runs this ferry service. Within the village, houses are not very close to each other, so one has to walk for many a mile as van rickshaws are incapable of traveling on the small mud roads. The area has a college, Sitananda College, popular as Nandigram College, affiliated to Vidyasagar University, and there are several schools, namely, Debipur Milan Vidyapith Nandigram BMT Sikshaniketan, Nandigram Girls High School, Asad Tala Binad Vidyapith Banamali Sikshaniketan, Riapura Girls High School, Kadam Bari Higher Secondary School, Nandigram Sitananda College, Samse Dad Dhanyakhola Vidyapith Rajaram Chak Sikshaniketan, Mohammadpur Subnarayan Sikshayatan Manuchak Milan Vidyapith, Durgapur High School Kultolya Balika Vidyapith, Narayan Chak High School, Akhandaberi High School, Ahmedabad High School, Nibedita Girls High School.